we are going to move on to our secondary colour, which, like, mix yellow and blue together, it should make green. Now, because that blue is so powerful, I am going to use a ratio of about 80% yellow to 20% green. So, with some nice clean water, what I am going to do now is just mix up my yellow. So we are mixing that powder and water together in really well, just to make a thick liquid. Remember, take care of the paintbrush. And just going to pick some out. You put it onto, you can use a palette or you can use the studio table. There we go, now I'm going to wash my paintbrush. So washing that paintbrush, I'm going to work it around the blue. Now I only want just a little tiny bit of blue, and I'm going to wash the rest away now because it is really powerful. So I've washed my brush, just dab off that excess water because you don't want too much water, and I'm going to mix them together. And I should have a green. It's a lovely shade of green. So, by now your painting skills should be getting better and better. So, let's just recap. We are starting in the centre. You can turn your paper to make it more comfortable. So we're starting in the centre. We are using the tip of the paintbrush to get nice controlled lines, nice controlled brush strokes. And we are working parallel to the edge of the shape. Pick up more paint when you need to. The lower down you hold your paintbrush, the more control you will have. So now we're looking to do the tertiary colours. We know that a tertiary colour is when you mix a primary and a secondary together. So I'm just looking to do the lightest one first. So yellow is lighter than blue. So if I mix more yellow into my green colour, I should get a tertiary green. So a really nice springy green. So I'm just going to wash my paintbrush before I touch that yellow. I don't want to contaminate the paint block. I've washed my paintbrush, please change your water if you need to, and I'm picking up that yellow. So I'm putting it beside the green rather than just mixing it straight in because we might need to go a few times picking that yellow out and I don't want to contaminate that paint block. So now I'm just mixing in the yellow and the green and I should have a really lovely lime green colour. Once you place it down, if you don't feel like it looks tonally different to the yellow and the green, then you need to keep mixing and you need to have a little think about whether you need to add more yellow or more green. Thank you. get a darker tone of green by adding in blue. So washing my paintbrush. My paint is getting a little bit thin now, so what I'm going to do is thicken it back up. So I'm going to mix some more yellow. Mix a bit more yellow, a nice thick yellow. What we don't want is really watery thin paint. So I've mixed some more yellow, and this time I'm really going to go for it with blue. I'm going to put quite a bit of blue in, and you should get like this sort of lovely turquoise teal colour. Yeah, I'm quite happy with that. I'm going to start off just in the centre and then work my way up. Small brush stroke. Not forgetting to pick up more paint when you use it when it starts to get a little bit thin. And then just pull in for that colour out. And there we go, we've got three different shades of green.